What's up, everybody? My name is Jeremy Jones, and I am back with another video. Today, we're talking to Air Jordan 1 Handcrafted. So stay tuned.
Changing in my life, hoping one day I'ma get it all right. Brother is engaged, about to start a new life. Yeah, I haven't had a chill day, really wanna vibe, appreciate the moments. I've been creating, not scrolling. Mom and dad still supporting.
All right, man, I'm back with another video, man. Before I get too deep into this video, y'all already know what to do. Go and hit that like button, it really helps the channel out. And if you're new, consider subscribing to make content about sneakers. All right, so let's dive into today's video. We're talking to Air Jordan 1 Handcrafted. All right, man, we're gonna be keeping things very simple over here today. We're gonna be answering a basic old question. Are they drip or skip? Let's just keep it there. All right, so first things first, these are set to release December 18th, to the best of my knowledge, coming in at a retail price of $170, right? Okay. Now, of course, the kid glanced at the resale price and looked like it's averaging about $220 and up, depending on the size, right? Okay. Now, not too much on the resale market just yet, but you know, Jordan 1s definitely hold their value no matter what the colorway is, right? Okay. Now, handcrafted. Now, it seems like right off the rip, these seems like they give me like Mocha Jordan 1 vibes, which did very, very well, right? And if you gotta mention the Mochas, God forbid right now, forgive me if I'm hurting anybody's feelings, but you gotta mention the Travis Scotts, right? Okay, and I'm talking about the Travis Scott Jordan 1s, right? Okay, but neither here nor there, man. Back to these handcrafted, man. Definitely a lot of stuff going on right here, just especially with the Jordan logo. Look like it's patched on. It looks like the way the stitching is on the sneaker, it looks like you can actually do some little customization. It doesn't necessarily say you can't, but it also seems like there's room for creativity, which I think that's where we're getting the handcrafted vibe from, right? Okay. Now, overall, man, I will say it's not a bad sneaker, just I feel like the timing for these is just not right there for me personally, right? Okay, but then again, like I just said, you can never really go wrong with a Jordan 1. So it's kind of like I'm really on the fence, right? Do I see these going up over time? Maybe, possibly slow is gonna be, but it will be that slow creeper, right? Okay, but for right now, for the kid, they're definitely gonna be a skip. There's a lot of heat dropping this week, and this just really isn't on my radar. Doesn't mean it's a bad sneaker, just like I said, you can't really go wrong with a Jordan 1. And honestly, it doesn't look bad, but then again, what Jordan 1 really does look bad at the end of the day, right? Coming down in the comment section, it, like, I can't even think of a Jordan 1 that I really necessarily don't like. There's some that like I'm not in love with, but if I had them, I wouldn't mind them. It's one of those, it's on the fence shoe, really, to keep 100. But overall, it's a skip for the kid. But I want to know what you guys think down in the comment section. And will you be going after these on December 18th, retailing at $170? And of course, let me know if you think they're drip or skip. All right, man, I'm gonna get up out of this thing and stop rambling, man. Y'all be sure to hit that like button. Really helps the channel out. And if you're new, consider subscribing. I make content about sneakers. Again, my name is Jeremy Jones, and thank you for watching, and I'm out. I freak out.